Welcome to EPG Pathshala. Today we are going to discuss the module titled History of Television Serials and Soap Operas. So far in this unit on History of Television, we have studied about the emergence of television technology, the emergence of satellite channels, and also the emergence and the history of Doordarshan. Also, we have analyzed how advertising helps television business to run. In the present module, that is History of Television Serials and Soap Operas, we will see how television serial has emerged in Indian broadcasting screen and how it has helped to bring the family together, what kind of genres it has catered to, and what is the basic difference between a television serial and soap opera. In doing so, we will also touch the important serials, also known as the important landmarks in the history of Indian television, and we will be discussing some of their themes in details and what role they have played in our society. So now let us begin our present module, which is focused on history of television serials and soap operas. The term soap operas evoke memories of Indian tear-jerker movies that are better known as melodrama. The usual format is love, romance, action, emotion, and happy endings. In Indian TV, soap operas have followed this model ever since they appeared on the horizon in the 80s. Over time, the basic ingredients remained the same. Indian soaps raised social issues in a largely patriarchy-dominated country, and over time, such programs became the driving forces of most TV channels in the country. However, since soap operas made their beginnings in US, we need to understand the historical underpinnings. It was over 80 years ago, back in the 1930s, that the term soap opera was first used by members of the American press to describe some of the first radio shows being produced and sponsored by companies of cleaning products. Since that time, soap operas have certainly gone through many transformations from the early days of radio broadcasting to full one-hour television format, and more recently into a new online format using Hulu and iTunes. Soap operas have not only been a part of American life, as some tend to think, but they have also played a large part in television history throughout many countries of the world. The idea behind the concept of television soap operas. Basically, a soap opera is a continuous or serial narrative in which a story is played out through connected episodes. A major feature of the traditional soap opera means each episode is open-ended and leaves loose ends with the promise it will be continued in future installment. The term cliffhanger is often used when referring to soaps and became even more prominent in the 1980s. During this time, CBS coined the advertising catchphrase "Who Shot JR?", which referred to the murder mystery cliffhanger of 1979-1980 season ending episode of Dallas. The huge success of this stunt by CBS dramatically impacted the use of how cliffhangers were used in television series and is still a part of today's most popular drama. Radio historian Francis Chase Jr. credits the early 1930s radio show The Smith Family as the great granddaddy of soap operas, which was only broadcast in Chicago on WENR. However, many credit The Guiding Light, which debuted on NBC Radio in 1937, as the first pioneer of the daytime soap opera. It is also said that during World War II, 64 other daytime series were being broadcast each week, and by 1948, the 10 highest rated daytime broadcasts on the radio were soap operas. Do you know, students? The mother of the soap opera was Erna Phillips, who created the first radio soap, Painted Dreams, and would later go on to create three giants in the field, The Guiding Light. On June 30, 1952, CBS television aired the first soap opera on American television sets when The Guiding Light became their four-year transition from radio to TV. By the early 1960s, there were no more radio soaps being broadcast in the US, and soaps were now strictly broadcasted on television. Now let us come to the Indian context after understanding the US history of television soap opera. India's first soap opera was Hum Log, which first aired in 1984 and concluded with 154 episodes. It was the longest running serial in the history of Indian television at the time it ended. It had an audience of 60 million. Every episode was about 25 minutes long, and the last episode was about 55 minutes. At the end of every episode, veteran Hindi film actor of yesteryears, Ashok Kumar, would discuss the ongoing story and situations with the audience using Hindi couplets and limericks. In later episodes, he would introduce the actors who played characters in the serial and end his monologue with the Indian language version of the words Hum Log. Another genre very popular on Indian television was biography. Biography of famous people started being produced in the form of soap operas. Meera was a biography of Meera. Veer Shivaji portrayed Chhatrapati Shivaji. Jhansi Ki Rani presented Rani Lakshmibai of Jhansi. Chanakya covered Chanakya. And Chittor Ki Rani Padmani Ka Johor portrayed Rani Padmani. Crime shows also started being produced and aired. Adalat was an Indian television courtroom drama series which revolved around advocate K.D. Pathak, a defense lawyer with an impeccable track record of winning cases and setting helpless innocent victims free, but not at the cost of upholding the truth. And CID followed a team of detectives belonging to the Crime Investigation Department in Mumbai. The protagonist of the show was Shivaji Satam. CID is the longest running TV series in India. Now let us bring our discussion to another important point. Is there any difference between TV soap and TV serials? Let us see. Indian media experts tend to have a different take on what is a TV serial and what constitutes a soap opera. A TV series is a show which is based on a particular concept and may fall into any genre of entertainment. It can be crime, action, thriller, horror, or romance. Much of the story of a TV series is planned much before the casting and principal photography. The number of episodes may or may not be planned well beforehand. However, the plots and events which would take place are already decided upon much before the release. There are less TRP stunts in these shows, as most of the typical TV series maintain their goal of portraying the story instead of coming up with illogical plot twist. Most of the shooting of a TV series is completed before the launch of the series. Now let us see how it is different from a soap opera, or what soap opera is. A soap opera is a slow-going, more digressive family drama series which stresses more on emotions and melodrama instead of some particular issue. A soap opera just has a broad storyline, and much of the story goes on developing on its own as the episodes are aired. It is the TRP which decides the fate of a soap opera. Soap operas stress more on family values and culture and may come up with different storylines at different times, involving a family member or stranger. Since these shows are TRP driven, they tend to be filled with TRP stunts and plot twists like sudden death or reincarnation of a family member, someone's kidnapping or marriage or prospect of becoming pregnant, and so on. These plots are decided to garner viewership. These shows in general do not represent some particular niche or practice of society. However, there are exceptions. Soap operas tend to continue over years and years if garnering TRPs, and if not, they wrap up within 6 months. Production of shows of this kind is less organized. Soap operas are generally low-budget shows. Watching a soap opera is like watching a parallel family to yours inside the television. We become a part of the family and continue to cherish the daily matters of the family, however illogical they may be. In other words, TV soaps are more voyeuristic in nature, and in pure commercial terms, they mark the difference between finite serials and infinite serials. To put the record straight, The lines have been so blurred that dramatic TV serials in India are more often than not referred to as TV soap operas. Now we will discuss the other important genre which occupies the maximum space in our television serials, which is the Saas Bahu sagas. In traditional Indian culture, it is said that when a woman marries, she doesn't just marry her husband, she marries his entire family. And her relationship with her mother-in-law can often be crucial to her survival in the bridal home. So nearly a decade and a half ago, when the first soap opera arrived based on the relationship between a mother-in-law and a daughter-in-law, kyunki saas bhi kabhi bahu thi, because the mother-in-law was also once a daughter-in-law, it struck a vital chord with its audience. The story of the imaginative Virani family centered on Tulsi, a young woman who falls in love with and marries Mihir Virani, the scion of a wealthy family. It had the country in thrall. The trials and tribulations of the pious and perfect daughter-in-law and her battles with the mother-in-law swiftly became a talking point of most homes. The first episode of Kyoki went on air on 4 July 2000 and it continued for nearly 8.5 years. In millions of homes across the country, families reorganized their daily routines to ensure they didn't miss out on the show. Shailaja Bajpayee, television critic for the Indian Express newspaper, says Kyoki's success was due to the fact that it was a universal story that appealed to everyone. In India, the family is paramount and the producer Balaji Telefilms cashed it on that. It was a winning combination of piety and family. Ms. Bajpayee says the show celebrated all the big festivals and it was all packaged very well and there was drama and melodrama. The unprecedented success of Kyunki encouraged Balaji to launch similar programs and many of them also went on to become huge hits. Nothing succeeds like success, says Shoma Munshi, professor of anthropology at the American University of Kuwait. Kyunki's popularity led to Kahani Ghar Ghar Ki and Kasauti Zindagi Ke and several others. The channels wanted more of the same time, just packaged in different flavors. Do you know, students? Ye Rishta Kya Kehlata Hai is the longest running Hindi soap opera in the history of Indian television, with at least 2,430 episodes having aired as of July 2017. The program has been airing since 2009. Tarak Mehta Ka Ulta Chashma aired at least more than 2,000 episodes and is the longest running sitcom serial in India. Balika Vadhu is India's third longest running soap opera, airing between 2008 and 2016. Coming to the criticism, let us see what social commentator Haneet Kaur has to say about Indian soaps and how they dumb down audience taste. Primetime television in India is not really known for sensible content, especially the soap opera. I have never been a fan, but one tedious evening I switched on the telly and sat through one Saas Bahu serial after another. What was it about family dramas that kept millions of Indian women glued to their TV sets each evening? I intended to find out. In one such episode, a mother-in-law laments the loss of an unborn grandchild. We have lost our grandson and our daughter-in-law cannot bear a child after this. Now we will never have a grandson to take the family name forward. I wondered how the mother-in-law could be so sure that the unborn child was a male. Did she get a sex determination test then, or was it some divine revelation? As the story of one other serial after the other unfolded on screen, I realized that to be the perfect woman on Indian television, one needed to be a submissive housewife and sacrifice everything for the family's happiness. Also, another important finding is that women who wear Western clothes or work for a living invariably have loose morals, or so these soap operas would have make you believe. It is a fact that millions of eyeballs are being exposed to such regressive programs day after day. In a report last year, the United Nations estimated that 2,000 unborn girls are illegally aborted every day in India. Experts warn that fewer women will spark a demographic crisis in India, which could lead to more crimes against women as there would be fewer left to marry. Then there are many kind of stereotypes which we also found in these television soap operas. Sasural Simar Ka is a soap with one of the highest TRP ratings, which means that when it airs on a private TV channel, several television sets all over the country are tuned to it. In one such promo, the future of Simar job hangs on the balance of a laddu tasting, and if she were to fail this tasting, she would have to quit her job. In another episode promo, her husband in a game with a man leverages one night with her. This portrayal of a strong and resilient family resounds through the scripts of Indian television shows. Characters conform to stereotypical roles of what society sees as normal. Any deviance is mocked to the point of disgust. Effeminate men and homosexual relationships are played insensitively for laugh, while the devotees of God-men, stay-at-home wife and overbearing mothers-in-law are presented as natural, inevitable and correct. Even women who work are depicted as aberrations so that they seem unreal. When TV serials do attempt to explore social problems, they inevitably succumb to absurd plot twists for the sake of ill-defined TRPs, which then remove the focus from the core of the social problem and it lapses sadly into distribution parochialism. Censorship too is a part and parcel of small screen. Balika Badhu, a TV show which ostensibly deals with the problems of child marriage, hardly focus on the trauma associated with being wed as a child. All the characters seem to live functional lives until the real villain appears, divorce. Thus, a conservative message, the sacredness of marriage, supplants the progressive one promised by the show's producer. These shows almost always depict middle-class Hindu families. They mutilate and misinterpret history to glorify a mythical golden age before the Muslim invasion of the Indian subcontinent. If serials such as Jodha Akbar find their way to the smaller screen, they encounter violent resistance from religious outfits that demand they may be banned on some pretext or the other. Many times producers too pull their names away from these serials. However, in the past year or so, there has been a whiff of change in the air. An Indian soap opera whose themes include acid attacks, domestic violence and high rates of abortion of female fetus has quietly become one of the most watched programs on the planet. India's public broadcaster announced in April that the audience for Main Kuch Bhi Kar Sakti Hoon, i.e. A Woman Can Achieve Anything, had in two seasons exceeded 400 million viewers and counting. Partly funded by UK foreign aid and designed by an NGO to promote sexual health and family planning, the enormous reach of the radio and TV series was unexpected, says Poonam, the executive director of the Population Foundation of India, who developed the program. Our estimate was that we would get 250 calls a day, she says of a hotline they established for viewers' feedback 3 years ago. First day, first show, we got 7,000 calls within 1 hour. Within 2 hours, our switchboard collapsed. By the end of the first season, more than 1.4 million Indians had called to comment on the drama unfolding around Sneha Mathur, the program's protagonist, who turns her back on a lucrative career as a doctor in Mumbai to practice in her home village of Pratappur. In one of the typically unflinching storylines for which the programs has become known, Mathur returns to her village after her sister is forced into a late-term abortion of a female fetus and dies during the procedure. To conclude, soap operas have been a cultural juggernaut in India since the early 2000s. When cable television reached an increasing number of middle-class homes, in a country where government can be marginal and sometimes malign, influence on people's lives, celebrities yield enormous power, says Shoma Munshi, an anthropologist and author of 2 books on Indian soaps. So with this, we have come towards the end of this another important module, that is History of Television Serials and Soap Operas. In this module, we have seen how the concept of soap operas emerged, we have seen its origin in the US and why the term soap opera has been used, because the early television serials or radio serials were sponsored by companies which were selling soaps, and hence the term soap operas came into the forefront. Then we have moved to the Indian context and we have seen what important programs were launched in Indian television. We started with Hum Log and we have seen how it was connected to people because it had simple story with simple characters, and in the end of the show, Ashok Kumar used to comment on the happenings of the television serial in a very swift and lucid manner. There were many important serials which came after that, and Ramayana and Mahabharata was one of those. But then another important landmark in the history of Indian television is the coming of Saas Bahu Sagas, which began with the launch of Kyunki Saas Bhi Kabhi Bahu Thi. It was a big year and a big launch, and with this television industry moved to another front where in-house drama became the major subject of television serials. The story focused on Indian homes, Indian families, revolving around women characters. Then we have seen how another genre of serials focusing on the biographies of important characters were launched. Towards the end, we have seen how some other important serials are fighting back to get justification and to proclaim about the social issues confronting women at the present times. Thank you for watching.